Hey guys, welcome to the channel. Today I'll be showing you how I created this best mom ever sublimation design in Inkscape, which is a free graphic program that you can download. Be sure to stick around to see how it was printed using Inkscape, as there is an additional step after saving the file in order for it to print correctly. If you would like to see more of these tutorial videos, remember to give this one a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. After opening Inkscape, I set the document properties to landscape, changed the units to inches, and set the size to 11 inches by 8.5 inches. I then imported a leopard print JPEG, which I already had on my computer. I then made a search for a sunflower with a transparent background, downloaded it and saved it to my computer. I imported the sunflower into the document and resized it to 4 inches by 4 inches. I clicked on the type tool and typed out the word best. I clicked on one of the corner arrows and dragged it out whilst holding the control key. This would increase the size proportionately. With the text highlighted, I clicked on path and then object to path. Using the type tool, I typed the letter M and changed the font type to impact. Holding down the control key while dragging on the corner arrow, I increased the size of the letter M. To change the shape, I first clicked on path, then object to path. I then clicked on the node edit tool and then clicked back on the letter. I pulled and pushed the nodes until I was happy with the shape of the letter. To rotate the letter, I clicked on the select tool, then clicked twice on the letter for the rotate options, then clicked and drag on one of the corner arrows to rotate it. To duplicate the letter, I right-clicked on it and then left-clicked on duplicate. I then clicked on the top M and dragged it down. I selected the letter to the back, then left-clicked on black in the color palette below. To add a stroke to the letter, I right-clicked on black in the palette, then left-clicked on stroke. If you don't see the outline of the back letter when you move the frontmost letter on top of it, you may need to adjust the width of your stroke under stroke style. I resized the leopard print to 4 inches by 4 inches and placed it behind the letter. I selected the frontmost M, then holding down the shift key, I clicked on the leopard print. Then I clicked on Object, then Clip, then Set. The clipped M was sent to the back. Select the black-filled M, then click on Lower Selection to Bottom, then move it into place. I selected the both M's by dragging over them with the Select tool. I right-clicked, then left-clicked on Group. I right-clicked and then clicked on Duplicate. I then clicked on Flip Object Horizontally. I moved the sunflower into position and brought it forward by clicking on Raise Selection to Top. I adjusted the letters by clicking on the arrow keys on the keyboard. I changed the color of the best text to black, then brought it forward and resized it. Using the type tool, I typed the word ever, resized it, then filled it with the color black. In the tool palette, I clicked on the Draw Freehand tool and just drew around the entire graphic, making sure that the nodes touch together at the end of the line. If your finish line does not appear as smooth as mine, you may need to adjust the smoothing. To change the line style, make sure that the Fill and Stroke tab is visible. Then click on Stroke Style, then click on the Dashes drop-down and choose your dash pattern. To adjust the thickness of the dash, click on the plus icon next to Width. I then fill the dash area with the color pink. I then sent it to the back by clicking on Lower Selection to Bottom. To add the filter, I clicked on Filters in the menu, then Scatter, then clicked on Air Spray. There are many filters available. You can play around with them until you find one that you like. To resize my graphic to fit the page, I press the Ctrl and A key on the keyboard to select everything. Then I clicked on one of the corner arrows while holding the Ctrl key to resize it. If you haven't done so already, now would be a good time to save your file. In order to print our sublimation design, we need to flip it horizontally by clicking on Flip Selected Objects Horizontally. In order to make sure our design prints correctly, we need to export it as a PNG file. Click on File, then click on Export PNG Image. Under the Export PNG Image window on the right, click on the Page tab. Under Image Size, set the DPI or dots per inch to 300. Then click on Export As. Choose your destination for your file and name it. Then click on Save. Next, click on Export. And a progress bar should pop up. Once that is done, your file has been saved to your destination folder. We now need to open the PNG file for printing. Locate and open it in Inkscape. Once it is open, click on File, then Print. Choose your printer and set your preferences. Click OK, then click on Print. I use a sawgrass printer for my sublimation prints, but it's fitted with refillable cartridges. I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you did, remember to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. Take care and bye for now.